A few years ago, a young woman from my hometown took her own life. She came from a loving family. She had a huge band of friends. The act was inexplicable. Such things always are. I was, as I'm sure you are, when you hear of such things, haunted by this. I couldn't take a walk without thinking about it. I couldn't stir a pot on the stove. I couldn't fold the laundry. The loss, that moment, the thing we can't fix, it just was always there. About this time, Harper Teen came to me and asked if I might contribute to a planned anthology of short stories called No Such Thing as the Real World, and because this was what was in my mind, this is what I've wrote about. A couple of you have been writing to me about this short story, and I've been moved by your notes, grateful for them, and thought I might read two pages from my piece, which is called The Longest Distance. It is fiction, but it is evoked by the feelings that such loss created in me. So, a reading. The rain by now was coming on strong. My towel was getting wetter, my hair streaking through. I wrapped my arm around my legs, rested my chin on my knees, shivered, and tried to stop myself from shivering, but I wasn't calling her back. I just watched her ride the storm. She splashed and went still. She splashed and went still. I could almost see her smiling. Even the boy with the shovel had left his dig. Except for a dog down the way, we were alone. The sky was all clouds and the sea was all gray. And then something spectacular happened. Something I remember now this night, just 22 days before I graduate. Out past Joelle in that storm, in that sea, came a gorgeous slice of silver. It rose, it fell, it rose again, and within it, she, the queen of the motes, was perfectly suspended. It took me a while before I understood that the dolphins had come to Joelle, that perhaps she had drawn them toward her. She waited for something, I'll never know what, then it reached out with her long arms to touch them. Then it was the most complete stillness, like nothing moved at all, not the dolphins, not Joelle, not the sea, nothing rising, nothing falling, the slightest hint of purple. The ocean just is, Joelle had said, and right then Joelle just was too. It wasn't purpose that she wanted in that one moment, but living, which is better. It wasn't questions, but answers. She was alive in the sea, in the storm. She was alive, she was happy, she was calm. This is so incredibly perfect. And this is the image that I wake with this night. Joelle in the company of dolphins, Joelle in balance.